Hello everyone, welcome to ComScholar. Let's talk in the context of National Education Policy 2020. The Union Cabinet Minister issued a policy in the year 2020 which talks about a massive change in the education sector and also focus on key reforms in the school education as well as in higher education. Now let's discuss what are the big reforms under this new education policy. The Education Minister first changed the name from Ministry of Human Resource Development to Ministry of Education to give more importance to education. Earlier, there were two policies. The first policy was implemented in 1968 and the second one was implemented in 1986. These two policies were to bring reforms in education sector and to accomplish harmony in India. Now, in the year 2020, that is after 34 years, the government has drafted National Education Policy to pave the way of education in all sections of the society and to reach education to every single person. Now, let's take what are the changes in school education. The central government has drafted under National Education Policy 2020 to replace the existing system with 5+3+3+4 curriculum. Basically, this new curriculum categorized into four stages. The first stage is foundational stage. Under this stage, the education will be given on the basis of activity-based learning, play-based learning, and the students will be taught language skill and how to identify things. For the first year, the student will be taught those who belong to the age of 3 to 6 years, and this will further enhance to first and second standard. The second stage is preparatory stage. This stage is for 3 years. Under this stage, the education will be given in mother tongue language or local language of that particular state. This stage is about more discovery, activity based and interactive classroom learning. The third stage is middle stage. Under this stage, the education will be experiment learning in all subjects such as science, maths, arts, social science, humanities, etc. The last stage is secondary stage. Under this stage, the education will be multidisciplinary study, critical thinking, and the students can choose any subjects as per their own interest. Now, what are the more changes in school education? Now, board exams will be at low stakes and tests will be conducted on the basis of actual knowledge instead of rote learning. Mother tongue to be a medium of instruction till 5th grade. Report cards will be a comprehensive report on skill and capabilities. All separations between vocational and academics and curricular and extracurricular will also be removed. Students to learn coding from 6th grade. Now, what are the changes in higher education? 50% gross enrollment ratio by 2035. Now, what is gross enrollment ratio? This is nothing but to determine the number of students enrolled in various universities at several different grade level. The education will be holistic and multidisciplinary education, that is flexibility of subjects. That means students can opt for any subjects as per their own interest. The MPhil will be discontinued. Public investment in education sector to reach 6% of GDP at the earliest. There will be a singular regulator for higher education, that is Higher Education Commission of India. Higher Education Commission of India, which will be a regulator for higher education. This will also provide funding. This will also give accreditation to all universities and colleges and maintain a standard in all universities. Now, due to COVID-19, this pandemic has disrupted face-to-face teaching learning for the students as well as for teachers. Now, the education will be provided on technology platform. So, to Divyang, the education software will be provided very friendly. The National Education Technology Forum will be implemented. This platform basically for free exchange of ideas on the use of technology, and all schools will be digitally equipped for teachers as well as for the students. A content will be provided in regional language. Now, what are the other vital reforms? Phasing out of affiliation system in 15 years, which means those institutions offering single streams, they will be phased out in 15 years. There will be an independent board of governors for every state for conducting all the universities and schools in their respective state. The education will be more focused on basic literacy and basic numeracy, and to provide education more transparently, self-disclosure for public oversight and accountability. The next point is foreign universities in India. Basically, the doors has been opened for the top 100 universities. This point has basically raised some criticism that education specialist thinks that the students cannot afford fees to get education in these universities. Now, what are the expected outcome from this national education policy? Universalization from ECCE to secondary education by 2013, 100% GER in preschool to secondary level by 2030, teachers to be prepared for assessment reforms by 2023, common standards of learning in public and private schools, that is to reduce the gap between public and private schools, inclusive and equitable education system by 2030, there will be more public spending in education sector, there will be cap fees in the private institutions so that they will not charge extra fees from the students. The education will be on the basis of learning, less stressful, that is there will be some bagless days in schools. Vocational course will be offered to all the students, such as painting, crafts, drawings, dancing, music. The students can opt for these vocational courses as per their own interest. Now, what are the challenges for the government to fill vacancies for the teachers? First one is pupil teacher ratio. As per the standards, the pupil teacher ratio will be 1:25:30, so that a teacher can concentrate on each and every student very carefully. The filing of vacancies for the teachers in disadvantaged areas, that is the government want to focus on to recruit all the teachers in rural areas or where there are less literacy rate. Local teachers will be given more preference because they understand the students' language and the cultures. Only the trained teachers will be recruited so that they can give a right education or right direction to every student. Now, let's take some frequently asked questions. First one is, how will students evaluate students? How will school evaluate students? In the new system, a combination of self-assessment by the student, peer assessment, and teacher assessment will be followed. The new education policy or national education policy seeks to equip students passing out from 12th grade to have at least one core skill. Now, what are the three language formula system here? The new national policy education policy recommends that all students will learn three languages in their school. Under this formula, at least two of the three languages should be native to India. Will there be any changes in board exam pattern? Board exams will continue for 10th and 12th standard, but the question papers will have more number of objective types of questions and redesigned with holistic development as the aim. The new assessment center PARC will be set up as a standard setting body. The PARC is basically an education platform for school as well as for the university's administration. What criteria will be followed for admission in higher education institute? After 12th grade, the National Testing Agency will conduct a single entrance examination for admission into higher educational institute in the country. What does multiple entry and exit for undergraduate course mean? Which means, if any student chooses to exit from the degree at any point during the course of the period, they have the option to return and start where they left. They are not required to start from their first year of undergraduate course again. What changes have been made under undergraduate course? Under the new undergraduate courses format, options have been given that include certificate after 1 year, advanced diploma after 2 years, bachelor's degree after 3 years, and bachelor's degree with research after 4 years. What is the minimum qualification needed for a teacher under new policy? The minimum qualification for teaching will be a 4-year integrated BA degree. A new and comprehensive national curriculum framework for teacher education will be formulated by the NCTE in consultation with NCERT. How will these reforms will be implemented? Since education is a concurrent subject, both the center and state government can make laws on it, but the reforms proposed can only be implemented collaboratively by the state and the center. Now, what are the challenges for the government to accomplish all the objectives? Whatever stated in this policy must bring into reality from the mutual effort by the state as well as central government. Hope this new education policy will bring a major transformation and must bring a strong foundation in the education sector. Thank you.